Good morning, student. Up till now, we have studied about the different topic that is called as the chemical coordination of in the human. Today, we have start here a new and different concept of the NEET exam and board exam called as the origin and evolution of the human being. We know that there are different characters which we have studied in the 11th standard. What is meant by the living organism? What is meant by the non-living organism? What are the characteristics of the living organism? The irritability, or it may be called as the responsiveness, then the growth, then reproduction. These are the characteristics of the living organism. The non-living organism does not have them. We do not need to say that whether the living or not living. But here the concept is about the origin of the human being or life on the earth. There are many interesting areas of human interest. But what happens here? The inquisitive mind of the human being try to find out how the life, when the life, and how this life took form on the earth. This is the interesting area of the study of human being. And there are many unanswered questions which are taking place in the mind of human being about the origin and evolution of life. We have tried to find out the answers of such questions about the origin and evolution of life. So first of all, we know that the origin of life on the earth is also called as another term that is called as protobiogenesis. So origin of life on the earth, that is the protobiogenesis, how it takes place, when it takes place, these are the questions we must try. There are many scientists in the world, they try to find out the answer of these questions. And for that purpose, they propose different types of theories, different type of propositions to find out the origin of Earth. Now, such a type of theories and propositions, they are given by the scientists in the course of time. Some of the scientists, they give the experimental proof. Some of the scientists, they does not give the experimental proof. Then also, the people at that time, they believe in these theories. Few theories which we have to study in this period. That theories, out of which the first theory, which is the oldest theory, and many people, majority of the people, they believe on this theory. This theory is called as theory of special creation. So the theory of special creation is the oldest theory, and which is put forth by the monk, particularly the father or priest of the church, particularly named as Father's Ray, named as Father's Ray. He put forth such a type of theory that is called as the theory of special creation. According to this theory, they said that the life is created on the earth by a supernatural power. We call it as a God. The God create different type of creatures in the world or on the earth. And this theory was majority people, particularly the civilized peoples, the philosophers, as well as majority of the religions. They support such a type of theory that the world or the life is created by the God or the supernatural power. But this theory is put forth by Father Subrayes without scientific evidence. They are unable to give the scientific proof of that thing, and that's why this theory is rejected in the course of time. But majority of the people today also believe in this theory of special creation. Second theory was put forth here by Rich and called as a panspermia theory, or which may be called as a cosmosphere theory. This theory was put forth by Rich in 1865. According to this theory, the Rich said that the life is originated on distant planet in the form of spores or in the form of microorganisms. Gradually they came on the earth. While through the journey through the atmosphere, they have to face through the friction. And he gave explanation about that. The spores or microorganisms, they are covered by a material. And that's why they reach up to the earth. They struck on the barren land, they break up and release the spore or the microorganisms. Such release the spores and microorganisms, then the spores germinate to produce different plant creatures, and the microorganisms, they gradually develop into the different type of creatures on the earth. When we study such a type of theory, it is clear that these scientists, though the Darwin is also believed such a type of panspermia theory, their spores which are present on distant planet and they are covered by the material called as a meteorites. They called it as the meteorites. The meteorites, when came on the earth, they struck the barren land, released the spores or microorganisms. They are called as cosmozoa. And such a type of cosmozoa, then they germinate and they produce such a type of new creatures in the world. This theory, when we study, it is observed that this theory explains the life on distant planet. And from distant planet, it comes on the earth. But this theory does not tell us about the life on the earth. And that's why this theory is also rejected. The third theory is named as a theory of abiogenesis, or it may be called as a theory of atobiogenesis. It may be called as a theory of spontaneous creation. So such a type of theory, this theory is put forth by the Greek philosopher. Greek philosophers, and these are also supported by the famous scientist Aristotle, Plato, Socrates, and many others. This theory is put forth near about 600 BC before Christ. So such a type of theory, supported by such a great scientist, father of biology, Aristotle, supports such a type of theory, and that's why the people believe in this theory, which is called as the theory of abiogenesis. What this theory tells us that? This theory tells us that the life is originated from the non-living things, spontaneously. So life is originated from non-living matter spontaneously. How it is happened? They said that the mud in the Amazon river, it will be developed into the frogs. The hairs on the neck of the white horse, they are developed into snake. The wooden logs, they are developed into barnacles and fishes. These are the few examples given by such a type of scientist, and this theory also believed by many people in the world. Gradually, they are showing that such a type of spontaneous creation takes place. But a majority of the effort is done by the other scientists. Such scientists, they also take the effort, give the scientific proof, and they discard such a type of theory. This theory, new theory, is put forth by the scientists named as theory of biogenesis. This theory was put forth by three different scientists at three different times. And they give the experimental proof, because majority of the people, they believe on the theory of abiogenesis. And that's why the theory of biogenesis must have given the experimental proof. The scientist named as the Francisco Redi. Second scientist was the Splanzani. And third scientist, famous scientist, named as the Louis Pasteur. These are the three scientists, they work on such a type of theory of biogenesis. And they disprove the theory of abiogenesis. For that purpose, they give the experimental proof, particularly the Francisco Redi. He take the three pots, glass pot. One is covered by parchment paper, and in the flask a flesh or a piece of meat is kept, and which is covered by parchment paper. Another flask he take, again he kept the piece of meat and covered by muslin cloth. He again take another pot, a piece of meat, and he kept open to that pot. What happens after some days? Some flies lay their eggs on this piece of meat, and a small larvae is to be seen. He named it as maggots. So maggots are seen here, and they said that life is originated from the pre-existing life through the reproduction, or by the reproduction. So theory of biogenesis tells us that the life is originated from the pre-existing life through the reproduction, and not from the non-living matter. The Louis Pasteur gave his the famous example of swan neck experiment. He take such a type of flask which has a swan-like neck, and he kept such a type of flesh of meat here. And he realized that by certain days, when such a type of the air or the flies goes into the flask, and they create the creatures. So such a type of Louis Pasteur also gives the experimental proof. And today also, in the laboratory of Paris, we have to see or we can observe such a type of swanness flux of Louis Pasteur. So Louis Pasteur gave the proof that life is originated from the pre-existing life and not from the non-living matter. Through reproduction, one organism gives birth to the other. All these evidences or theories tells us about the origin of life on the earth, that is the protobiogenesis. And all these are the conclusions of the theory. But they does not give the experimental proof. Then some scientists, they came together and they put forth the new theory, which is accepted all over the world, and that is called as a self-assembly theory. This self-assembly theory was put forth actually by the scientist Hacking. But this theory is explained by two scientists. One of them is called as Alexander Popperin, Russian scientist Alexander Popperin, and a second scientist from the Great Britain named as J.B.S. Hellman. J.B.S. Hellman. These two scientists, they elaborate the basic imagination or basic theory of Hacking and put forth the chemical evolution in front of us, and that is called as a self-assembly theory. The base of theory is that the chemical molecules, which has an inherent property of self-organization, they came together, self-organized together, and they form the matter. Just like that, they are calling that all non-living chemical matters, they came together, self-organized, and the cell-like microsystems are formed. The basic proposition is that the micromolecules, they came together and first of all form the macromolecules. Then certain macromolecules, they come together to form cell-like microsystems. And different scientists also give the proof of such a type of theory also, particularly named as the Smith. The scientist, he took particularly the simple matter, simple inorganic matter, and he prepared the collagen fibers or collagen protein from such a type of matter. Another proof is given by the scientist Reed. He took particularly two amino acids, and these two amino acids, they are heated and they produce enzymatically active complex. Now, nowadays, we have also read about the tobacco mosaic virus. What this virus contain? This virus contain only the two components. One of them is nucleic acid and another is the protein coat. So this theory is seen to be the theory which is to be believed by majority of the people, and for that purpose he stepwise described the theory one by one. So today we have to learn here this theory about the origin of Earth. So today we have studied here this theory one by one. The first step of theory which we have to complete today, and the other we will see later on. The first step is that the actually origin of Earth. There are many questions in the mind about the origin of Earth. But it is said that Earth is originated about 20 billion years ago. How this Earth is originated? Earth is originated by single Titanic explosion. Where it happens? It happens at Sun. Single Titanic explosion occurs at the Sun and the Earth is originated. How it is to be originated?